Okay, this is I'm gonna start it and power feed. Now this is huge for me. I never even had a power feed that worked at first. It's given me more confidence in my cross slide feed. I was always a little leery of letting it have too much torque. I'm just all kinds of chip of the week material here. Kind of a little anomaly in the cut there. Probably the chip probably just got caught up somewhere and then released. Too bad we're not just making chips here. I'm doing pretty good. Okay, this is I think copper hammer part 5, the handle. And once again, you know, the drawing may not be a true representative of the finished part. I'm going to make a bi-metal handle. So there's my some brass comp, brass copper alloy. I don't know. It's not pure brass. It's not pure copper. It may not be any copper in it at all, but it's a... So this is going to be the main body of the hammer, and we'll have those inserted into the handle somewhere. I'm going to go for something like this, where this is just going to disappear down inside the body. And that'll be locked tight in. So hey, enjoy the video. Thanks, guys. Okay, we're back on the copper hammer. And I have two different alloys of brass, I think. If not, I have an alloy of copper and an alloy of brass. And we're gonna clean both those up a little bit and get them both uniform in diameter. And we're gonna cut off some discs. And we're going to marry them all together. We're going to bi-metal handle. And we're going to do 490 RPMs. A, two. We'll face this off.
I think is 10,000. This in back gear and give me a little holding power. I think this is almost going to be worth less is more here, I think. Unless we bust a tap off in here. So I can get enough just for. There must be some threads in there. There's 800,000. So that's gonna meet my needs. Pick off of here. This one's got a tiny little hook on it. That was hanging out up in there. Well, I got much deeper. Well, this is kind of an oddity. You can see the end here, that's a set screw. And it's got a hex on the end. That's a long ass set screw. Yes, indeed, that is one very long set screw. I'm not sure if my power feed could handle this torque or not. I guess there's one way to find out. No, there's power feed. Okay, I'm gonna stop that because I think we've bottomed out somehow. Okay, why was that stopping? That's why. Okay, this is the chip from parting in the power feed mode. And I believe one continuous chip. I never saw that break. I'll call that chip of the week. Okay, this is I'm gonna start it in power feed. Now this is huge for me. I never even had a power feed that worked at first. Giving me more confidence in my cross slide feed.
I was always a little leery of
letting it have too much torque. I'm just all kinds of chip of the week material here. Kind of a little anomaly in the cut there. Probably the chip probably just got caught up somewhere and then released and. Too bad we're not just making chips here. I'm doing pretty good. Okay, that's it for part five of copper hammer handle. So thanks for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing. Tell a buddy, bring a friend. Good day. Well, what do you think, Buzzbo? Where'd Gordy go? The dogs are settling in here.